Let's find out how to use VMlogin with proxies. Kick things off by launching the VMlogin app and tapping on the new browser profile. Think of a name for your profile. Now, let's add proxies in VMlogin browser settings. Press the Setting Proxy Server button to get started. In the new window, turn on the toggle switch to Enable Proxy Server. Regardless of your chosen proxy type, the process is similar. Today, I'll show you how to set up residential proxies. So, start by selecting the HTTP proxy in the drop-down menu. Okay, now you need to get an IP and port number. You'll find these at the Smartproxy dashboard. After logging in, go to Proxy Setup. In the Authentication Method field, type in the username of your choice. Hit Create. The password is generated automatically. And move on to the Endpoint Generator section. Now input your preferred proxy location, session type, and output format. The generated endpoints will appear below. Okay, copy the endpoint and port. If you're using dedicated data center proxies, copy IP address and port. Now go back straight to VMlogin. Now enter the IP address and port number in their respective fields. Then type in the username and password you've created in Smartproxy's dashboard. Don't forget to click the Test Proxy button to test your proxies. Great! Now hit Save. You can finish up by tweaking the rest of the profile settings. Choose operating systems, language, fingerprinting options, and other parameters. Once you're done, save the profile and you're ready to use it. All of the links are in the description below. For more helpful videos like this, check out our YouTube channel and documentation.